Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Kiska birthday, bro? Dude, it's the birthday of the day. What day? The day when 6 years ago, the course of the Indian internet changed. This is a fascinating story about zombies, about bomb blasts, about your right to meme on the Indian internet, about two brave girls and about your future. You're gonna wanna hear this. So, India has had the internet since like the 1990s. Now, obviously, we need some rules to govern what we do on the internet. Otherwise, we're just in a lawless land. These rules have been evolving over the years under something called the IT Act. Now in 2006, a bill was passed jisne cyber terrorism, child porn, online sexual harassment jaisi cheezon ko criminalize karne ki koshish ki. This same bill also sought to make unlawful, offensive, damaging or hurtful messages online. Ab tum socho, tum mujhe koi message bhej do aur main bol do, man, I'm super offended. This is unlawful. Police, arrest this man. Obviously, that's ridiculous. So this bill, as bills tend to be, remained under consideration for a while. Lekin phir 2 saal baad, unfortunately, Mumbai mein 26/11 ke terror attacks hue. And the parliament jaldi passed a number of bills on priority without any debate or discussion, keeping in mind the urgent national security situation in the country. The whole country was like in a state of panic. And one of these things was amendments to the IT Act, which included the penalizing of sending offensive messages online. This came to be known as, and you're gonna hear this super frequently whenever you're talking about free speech online, Section 66A of the IT Act. Now, would anyone like to tell me what happens when you penalize sending offensive messages without ever really defining what offensive means? I can tell you what happens. All hell breaks loose. That is right. Hundreds of people started being arrested under Section 66A, just left, right and center. It could really be applied to anybody. And of course, then people started using it for like malicious purposes. They were misusing it. They were using it for their personal vendettas and to further their own vested interests. A lot of the memes that we post even today may not actually have survived under Section 66A of the IT Act. And trust me, you think free speech in India is threatened right now? I mean, yeah, it is. But it was really threatened back then. In 2012, something unfortunate happened in the city of Mumbai yet again. Political leader Bal Thackeray passed away, and for his funeral, a Mumbai Band was announced. Now, two young women took to social media just to question, कि अगर एक पॉलिटिकल पार्टी का लीडर की डेथ हो गई है, then why is the rest of Mumbai enduring a band? And people were outraged. These two women were taken into judicial custody and charged under Section 66A. And thankfully they got bail. But then everyone was like, इसका क्या मतलब हो गया कि अब हम ट्वीट भी नहीं कर सकते, कुछ बोल भी नहीं सकते सोशल मीडिया पे, out of fear of getting arrested? That's ridiculous. Even the headlines at the time were like super dramatic. They were all tweet at your own risk. Uske baad the wheels started turning. People said enough is enough. We have the right to free speech, by the way, and we can't go on living in fear like this. So a number of petitions were filed in the Supreme Court challenging Section 66A. And then 6 years ago on this day, the Supreme Court finally came to a decision in a judgment called, drum roll please, the Shreya Singhal judgment. In this judgment, the Supreme Court just struck down Section 66A completely. Matlab unhone bhi bol diya that this is so totally unconstitutional that we cannot have it as a rule at all. In the same judgment, the Supreme Court also held that social media companies can't be held liable if their users post some illegal content, and that the onus is on the authorities to let the social media companies know ki kisi content ko nikalna hai, take down karna hai. This was a big deal because in a weird way it made the internet a fairer place. Because now these large social media companies that are profit oriented did not have to legally exercise too much control over what people like you and I post online. But yes, there is always a but. It's not all been puppies and rainbows. We found that people are still being charged under Section 66A and kind of frequently. Because this was a Supreme Court judgment, alright? And sometimes high courts are like, oh, we didn't even know that the Supreme Court struck this down. Or sometimes maybe they just don't care that the Supreme Court struck it down. Either way, Section 66A has become kind of like a zombie, in the sense that it should have died, but it keeps coming back up alive. Also, by the way, there were some other parts of the judgment that were pretty cool as well. For instance, they had to do with when social media companies can censor us and when websites that have been blocked can, you know, challenge this in court. Unfortunately, these have also not been completely realized. And I know it's complicated, but trust me, real life is just simply more complicated than constitutional law, especially when it comes to matters of the internet. But we promise to carry on with your support. You know why things get so messy sometimes? It's because these new rules and laws constantly fail to prioritize the digital rights and interests of citizens like you and me, of regular users like you and me. This is exactly why we run as an organization, because we want to make your rights the priority in decisions like this one. Ab main aapko ek interesting cheez batau. Shreya Singhal verdict to 2015 mein aa gaya. Lekin aaj 2021 mein it is way more important. Kyun? Because our number of internet users has soared. We literally make up the largest groups of Facebook, WhatsApp and YouTube in the world. इसीलिए जब हम हर रोज बैठ के सोचते हैं कि भाई फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच का मतलब रह क्या गया है इंडिया में, we may always remember that the Shreya Singhal verdict happened. It still holds today. It is the word of the Supreme Court, and it serves as a reminder कि जब हम सब एक साथ जुड़ जाए, when we all come together and fight for our digital rights in a time when they're honestly, you know, not really doing so well in India, there is a chance that we may actually win.